Good morning and welcome to your grammar class, children. After finishing our chapter number 6, we are going to start our new chapter, that is chapter number 7, verbs. You all open up your books and see chapter number 7, we have verbs there. Children, if I ask you in a general way, what is the meaning according to you? What do you think the verb is? You all will say, I'm sure, action verbs. We have learned this, verbs means action words. Definitely they are action words. I am eating an ice cream. Now the word eating is an action done by me. I am eating an ice cream. So this is your action. Let's see what else the definition of verb says. This is verbs chapter number 7. The verb is a part of speech which is used to demonstrate an action or a state of being. Action, I have told you what it is. The examples are there. The boys laughed loudly. Laughed loudly, it means that laughed, that is the action. The soldiers marched bravely. In this, what is your verb? Marched is the action word. Now, and the definition also says, or this also explains you, it says demonstrate an action, that I have told you what action is. Whatever you do, that is your action. Or a state of being. State of being means, I'm giving you one example by which you can make out what state of being refers. Harsh. Was. Play. Happy. In. Delhi. Harsh was happy in Delhi. This is one of the examples of state of being. The word was is showing you that what is the state of being is that Harsh was happy in Delhi. Children, if somebody will ask you what words you can use for state of being, so you can say am, was, is, all these, etc. All these can be used to show the state of being. Alright, now one more, although it is not in the book, but I want to tell you that verb also have one category. We have talked about actions, we have talked about state of being. Now one more thing is there, that is mental verb. In that, what sort of word comes? I thought, I guessed, I considered. One example I will write for you. Considered the job done. See, I considered means this, when you think of something with your means mental, when you think of something, from which part of the body you think? Of course, from your brain. So the things which you are thinking, they comes under mental verb. Like I considered, it can be I thought. It can be I guessed. Okay, so all these words comes under your mental verb. So I have told you three categories: action words, adverbs, state of being, that is also one of the type of verb, and then mental verb. Here, after understanding all these things, all sentence must have verb with a subject. Now, to understand the verb, first of all, or to understand this chapter, first of all, you should be clear with three things. What are those three things? The three things are subject, your verb, and your object. If these three things are clear in your mind, then there won't be any difficulty in understanding any point in this chapter. Subject, I think you all know, but still I will revise with you. Subject is in the sentence. If I ask you to find out subject, I have already told you and explained you this earlier. Subject is the one who is speaking in the sentence or about whom we are talking in the sentence. Suppose if I am saying Ramesh has got 5 rupees, it means I am talking about whom? Ramesh. Ramesh has got 5 rupees. I am talking about Ramesh. So Ramesh is your subject. When we come to verb, I have explained you what verb is, isn't it? Your action word, the state of being, and your mental verbs. Now we have objects. Children, objects, that too I have explained you, but since this chapter has a very object has a very main role in this, so I want to revise this with you once again. Objects are of two types. They are of two types. One is direct object, another is indirect object. And if somebody will ask how you can make out which is direct object and which is indirect object, then also you keep this in mind that direct, for direct object you have to ask the question what. For direct object you will ask the question what, but for indirect you will ask the question whom. When you will get the answer of whom and what, accordingly you will understand that whether direct object is there or indirect object is there. Although in this we are only going to talk about the direct object, when we will clear our doubts and clear ourselves with transitive verbs, when I will explain you transitive verbs, then I will tell you there we are going to talk about only direct objects. Okay, so now our next heading, I hope this is clear to you. Now our next heading says object of a verb. How to find out that object of the verb? I have explained you two things. What, you will ask the question what when you have to find direct object in the sentence. Whom, when you have to ask indirect question. Indirect, when you have to find indirect object from the statement. So let's see. When we are talking about object of the verb, one example I will write for you. The boy throws. Another I will write for you. The child picks. Can you tell me, children, these statements are complete or not? Definitely you will say no. They are not complete. The boy throws. Now the thing is what it throws. What? The child picks. Again the question if I say the child picks. Only if I say child picks. You will think that what child is picking. You don't know what he or she picks. When I will tell you the child picks flowers. The child picks flowers. Now the statement looks complete. In the same manner, when I will tell you the answer for the question what, you will get the answer. The boy throws what? You will write a ball. You can add anything here, children, definitely. Here in this blank, you can fill anything. Just I am telling you just for the explanation. So, the statement says the boy throws a ball and it says the child picks flowers. So, if I ask a question from you, what does he throw? He means the boy. What does he throw? If I ask, what answer you will give me? Your answer will be, this will be your answer. If I ask you here, what does he picks? If the child is male or if the child is female, then I will say, what does she pick? You will get the answer, the child picks flowers. So flowers is here your answer. I have told you when you will get answer of the question what, then they are known as your direct object. So when you have asked the question what, you have got the answer a ball and flowers. So they are your direct object. This is also your direct object. This is known as object of a verb. Verb is throws and picks, isn't it? They are actions. Actions are shown here. But the action is showing what? On which the action is taking place? On a ball. Here, throws a ball means on a ball the action is going. And here, picking up the flowers, this is your one of the actions. So by this, I think I have made this clear to you what are object of the verb. And what are verbs. So that's all for today. Keep on revising this chapter number 7. And in the next video, we are going to learn about transitive and intransitive verbs. Till then, take care.